This is what you should see once you have connected to a data source. Lucas Studio will randomly add a chart to your canvas, which is the white space that you see here at the back. First, let's rename our report. Go to the top left corner and rename your report. You can always go back to Lucas Studio's homepage by clicking on the Lucas Studio's logo. Now, we're going to look at the menu and also the toolbar, which is right under the menu. We're not going to spend too much time on the menu because its most important features are made available in the toolbar. For example, if I was to click on the Insert tab, we can have the option to add charts to our canvas. But then again, there's a better way to do this using the toolbar section. You have Page, here you can add pages to your report or look at the current page settings. And Current Page Settings allows you to change the settings for a specific page in your report because a report can have multiple pages. But we'll talk about this later in the customization section. Now go to the Resource tab. Here you have different options and I'd like you to focus on Manage Added Data Sources. Here you have the data sources available for the current report and you can also add a data source and select a data source here. That's if you want to have multiple data sources in your report. I'll go back to the Manage Added Data Sources. You can also edit a data source, more about this in the customization section. You can duplicate a data source or remove a data source from your report. Now let's look at the toolbar section. The first feature of the toolbar section is undo and redo so that you can undo or redo any action performed on your canvas. Then we have the selection mode. And selection mode allows you to click on a component and select it and drag it around. You have then the zoom option. The zoom feature allows you to zoom on a specific component or area of your report for more detailed work, for example. To go back to the default view, simply click on the drop-down arrow and select default. Right now, we only have one page on our report, and it is the one that you see right now that we're working currently on with the table chart. To add a page, click here on Add Page. Look at the right side on the report pages, and now you'll see that we have two pages. The first page is the one that has our table chart, and the second one, the untitled page, is the empty canvas. You can always rename your page by double-clicking on the pill here. You can also do so by clicking on the three vertical dots and rename your page, duplicate your page, delete your page, and hide your page in the view mode. And we'll talk about view mode a bit later. You can also change the order of your pages. Simply hover on it, click, and then drag, and order your pages the way you want. Now, speaking of view mode, let's go back to our page first. View mode allows you to see how users will see your report and interact with it. Go to your top right corner and click on the view button. This is exactly how users will see your report. To go back to the report editor, click on edit. To access your pages, you can always hover on this section and click manage pages and find your pages again here. Now, you can add again a data source by clicking on add data. So if you want to have a report that has multiple data sources or have a specific chart that has a specific data source, you can use this option. Now we can add charts. Go to add a chart. And here you'll see the options that we have visually as charts that you can add to your reports, which is much better than the option we had before with inserts in the menu section. We're going to talk about charts a bit later in more detail in the charts section, where we're going to help you understand which charts you can use for which situation. Just to have a quick overview, here we have table charts, scorecards, time series charts so that you can see how your data trends over time and identify patterns. You also have bar charts and pie charts so you can understand the distribution of your data. You got maps like Google Maps and geo charts, line charts, area charts, scatter charts for your scatter plots, pivot tables, bullet charts. These are very good if you have target goals, tree maps for your cohorts or your different groups, and Sankey charts and Gao charts. Let's select the pie chart. Click on it and then click anywhere you wish on your canvas. Now let's look at community visualizations and components. Click on Explore More. Community visualizations and components allow you to enhance your reports. For example, you noticed earlier that we were able to add bar charts to our report. Now these bar charts are static. With the animated bar chart by Analytics Buddy, you can visualize and animate your charts, meaning that the community gallery allows you to improve and increase the possibilities for your components. You can add also a control. Click on Add Control and you find different options here. Mainly, you can use, for example, a drop list. This is where you can add a data and then filter your components and your other charts by this control. Think of controls as a way to filter components on your charts. So if I was to click here, and let's say that I was just interested on the homepage, I could just select homepage only. And if I was to click outside, now all the data will be filtered just by the homepage. I'll delete this. Another good control to know is the date range control, found in most dashboards and reports. Here now you have the option to select a date range. Or if you were to go on the view mode, your user has now the option to come and select a date range of their liking to analyze the data the way they want. Here I'm selecting May 1st and May 31st to have 1 month of data available. Now we're looking at the report based on this current date range. Here you have the option to embed a URL, and to give you an example, I'll just delete what we have here. Click on URL embed, click anywhere on your canvas. Now in URL embed properties, you can go and paste your URL. Here is one of our YouTube videos. All right. You also have the option to add images to Looker Studio. Go here, click on image, use a URL or upload it from your computer, which is what we're going to do now. And I'll just select the Measure School logo. And here you have your image. You can also have the option to insert a link. And then you have the option to add shapes like lines, arrows, and elbow connectors and curve connectors. You can also add rectangles and circles. You can also change the color. I'm going to background and change the colors. And again, we're going to look at customization later. And lastly, we're going to look at theme and layout. Let me just change this quickly. Let's add again table chart. If you go here at the right, click on theme and layout. So themes and layouts are the predefined colors and also settings that you can change in Looker Studio. Here, for example, we are using the current default theme, and we could change this, for example, to this one, like constellation. But don't worry, again, we're going to cover customization later, where we're going to also share some pro tips to supercharge your dashboards. Perfect! We know now how to access Looker Studio and how to get started quickly with templates or how to start dashboards and reports starting from scratch. We also have now a very good understanding of the report editor. Now let's move on to connectors. Let's learn how to link your data to Looker Studio with connectors. Connectors fetch data from a platform and send it to Looker Studio. For example, if you had Google Analytics installed on your website and were interested in visualizing this data in Looker Studio, you could then use the Google Analytics connector. There are three types of connectors: Google connectors, partner connectors, and community connectors. Google connectors are free and give access to Google marketing products like Google Sheets, Google Analytics, and Google Ads. Partner connectors are paid and offer additional capabilities. Examples of well-known partner connectors are from Supermetrics. Their connectors can help pull and format data correctly for Looker Studio from various sources like Facebook Ads, Twitter Ads, Google Analytics, and then have them all in one place like Google Sheets, which can then be used as a data source for Looker Studio. Community connectors belong to the Looker Studio community program and can access various platforms, including public and private company data. For this tutorial, we'll cover how to add data from Google Sheets and Google Analytics 4 using their respective connectors.